All right, plug this here Dremel back in. I wasn't gonna do the river, but my youngin' convinced me I should. Now, and of course, like a typical river, the lines are kind of jagged, and I kind of got it to follow the grain, which is kind of the reason why we both thought it'd be a good idea to do it. So, locate the switch. I will stop shy of the bevel.
Thank you.
it around. And I'm absolutely being reckless here, I know. And this out the damn way. And that down here. So, here we go. We just punched through. That's all right, though. There we go. And you know, if some pieces of wood are still in there, it can be like rocks in the river, you know? But, like I said, punched a hole here through here where there was a knot hole. But, because we're working with epoxy, that don't matter. I just put a piece of tape down here on the underside. And that epoxy will just fill it right in. So, signing off till the next step. See, we have super glued the plug in the cavity. And shortly, I'll be flipping it over and starting the inlay process. See, this time, instead of super glue, I am going to attempt wood glue. You know. seriously this. That's going to work. Okay. Never mind me, I'm just over here mumbling to myself. Crazy. I gotta. Well, like I said, this, everything about this build has been an experiment, you know? I'm thinking. You know, whatever doesn't stick to that, I have this. Just like when I did the lightning, you know? This process might be kind of wasteful, but still a bit of a messy process, though. So, on that note, figure out. My lantern box. Place to dump all this extra glitter. And there we are. I'll epoxy it later when the glue dries. Okay, now that I pretty much have sealed the most of this, I've got to put another layer on. Build it up so I can level it. Boy, when I put a clear coat on that boy, it is gonna mirror finish. For a spreader, old lockout tagout card. Whoa, back up there. Let's not be. There we
are. Just, you know, filling in the low spots here. Shouldn't take near that much. Alex. Yeah. I just keep it spread over this way. Yeah, that wasn't cool. I'll have to mix up a little just for a spot there. Hey, cat. Real quick here. You know, while I have everything ready, I can just pop that off there, squirt me a little more. Hell, that'll probably do it right there. And there we have it, for the most part. We've pretty much everything sealed. I'm just building it up so I can level it. So there we are. And that concludes this segment. All right. Little work leveling all the epoxy work I did on the face of it. Humidity's too high for me to even think about putting any back here today. Those might require something a little more stout. 120 grit.
sure I'm not leveling, I'm removing. Okay, so that's, because I'll have to do a lot of hand sanding possibly there, but mainly what I want to do here besides drop my tools is, let's see, yeah, there it is, go back to 220. Just trying to level off the high spots. Being epoxy, it's pretty, a lot more stout than, say, clear coat. We took off a good bit there. Now, let me see here. Yikes. I can set that there. Pretty much now, locate me another piece of 220 here. I'm probably used it all. Ah, here's a good one. I got a soapy water solution here. The, you know, kind of wet sanding as I go too, so.
just hit it this way. And now I haven't put any finish on this yet. I'm gonna seal the body with the epoxy. So that I only gotta put a handful of coats of clear on it. Hell, I'm about the point now. You know, power tools make quick work of the high spots. About the point now where I could darn near buff this out and call that a finish if I wanted, but we gotta take it that next step. Well, I'll tell you what, huh? About out of 220. But I'm going to use the hook and loop side here. Kind of dry that off a little. Kind of get an idea what it's going to look like. And I'll tell you what, some of the grain anomalies in this slab I used for the body wings. Unreal. As soon as the humidity goes down a little bit, I can finish my epoxy work. But for now, I can try to level these sides a little bit. Back to the 120 for this.
Maybe even remove some of it. besides nowhere near as bad. That's a little. Well, next step I'm going to attempt over here is quite possibly buffing that out, seeing what I get. All right, I'm going to polish these frets up. And I'm going to do it a different way this time around. Because I don't have the buffing wheels for the Dremel. I'm out of buffing compound for my cloth buffing wheel. So, I have the tape down. This is, the main reason I have the tape down is so I can do it this way. It's an experiment, obviously. Okay, we'll just... And that should be enough. The Meguiar's Ultimate Polish, that's some good stuff. And I can plug the drill in. It unplugs itself almost immediately. There. Just one of those things, I suppose. Yeah. Okay. I'm already over this mess. This nonsense. So, put a spring to it where it's, there it is. I dare you. All right, make sure there ain't nothing on this, because that would defeat the whole purpose. This way. And you see where a bunch of stuff come off there. Now that sucker may be toast after this use. Then I find this stuff works good, like on a finish, obviously you're not keeping all this on here. But I've always, it's a mild cutting compound. I can pretty much peel most of this off right here. Just, you know. I'm actually pretty happy with how it looks just so far. I mean, pretty much all I gotta do is just give it a wipe down. I have to do this because I can't really do any more finish work. Because the epoxy and even clear coat do not do well in humid environments when it comes to curing and behaving correctly and all that. At least why I've never had any luck with it. I mean, your results may vary. Or your results may differ, however you want to put it. But I'm definitely, I mean, are they going to be perfect? Doubtful, but you know, I'm just a guy that either works outdoors or works in a very cramped shed. So I do what I can, you know. But, you know, here lately, though, coming up with ideas like this, I've been watching guys like Scar My Guitar, Heavy Metal ATC, when he's got a video up. And here we are. My hand, give it a wipe down, just like, you know. Yeah, I mean, shoot. Is it perfect? No. But they've been leveled, sanded up to 1,000 grit, hit them with the buffing compound. Redneck hacker signing off. All right, so now we got the handy dandy Dremel here. And of course, make sure we're pointing the right way. Android phone, the camera likes to do that 180 degree flip at the drop of a hat. And from this side, you can't really tell. So what I got to do is I've got to massage the opening here where the driver is going to go. This should be fun. And of course, there's other sanding I've got to do yet to inside horns here, kind of blend where body meets the neck a little bit. But for right now, I just wanted to get this opening ready. Pretty much, face is sealed. The headstock here is pretty well sealed. I'm just gonna, once I get the horn here, inside the horns here taken care of, I'll hit the neck back here, smooth it up a little bit more, and I'll be ready to start finishing it. And then while the finish is drying, I'll wind that driver. And I'll tell you what, that's going to be a video all by itself because I've never done that before. Probably a lot of swearing involved, but hopefully we'll get through it. But for now, I'm signing off.